Have you ever explored the text properties in Photoshop or tried to write exponent characters, trying to change the placement of alphabets, colors, or the distances between letters in a word or sentence? Today, in this tutorial, we will look at a few text properties. Other than the basic properties, what else offered by Photoshop, which can improve your text editing skills in Photoshop? So, let's get started. For a beginner, basic text properties are include font type, weight and size, color and weight. So, if you want to create text art, distort the text to create an innovative text design, for example a logo or branding, or the text effects for a title, or to emphasize the text in a specific artwork, Photoshop provides few text properties that can help you create innovative designs. Let's see what are the properties offered by Photoshop. To check the properties, insert a text by using text tool. Select the text. The properties related to text will display in the properties bar. Click on Toggle the Character and Paragraph option. It will allow you to set the paragraphs and also allow you to toggle around an individual text. Let's see how it affects individual text. These are few options of Toggle the Character and Paragraph panel, which can be found in properties bar also. Font type, font style, and font size. Apart from these options, there are a few more options. Leading, kerning, and tracking. Horizontal and vertical scaling of fonts and paragraph. Baseline shift and color option. Let's see how each options affect an individual text. We will not discuss basic properties of text. First option is leading, which found only in the character panel, which allow user to adjust the gap between type line. It will not work on single type line. You must have two or more type line. By default, it is in auto mode. To change or adjust the gap, first, select the text using text tool. As you can see, leading provides points value to adjust the gap. Lesser point value reduce the gap between two lines, whereas higher point value increase the gap. Next option is tracking, found only in the character panel, which allow users to adjust the amount of space between a range of letters or characters. To set tracking for the selected character, first, select the characters where you want to apply. Then choose the amount of gap or distance from the tracking drop-down. It provides negative and positive values. By default, the value is 0. If you choose positive value, it will increase the distance between all letters equally. Similarly, if you choose negative value, it will reduce the distance between all letters equally. Higher negative value will overlap the letters on each others. To make it easier to understand, I've colored each letter a different color. I manually enter the highest negative value, 200, by selecting and typing. You can see the difference because the letters are overlap each other. To apply, click on tick button on properties bar. You can feed the value manually. By default, the highest negative value is 100 and positive value is 200. Next option is kerning, which allows you to adjust distance between two characters or alphabets. To kerning, place the cursor in between two letters where you want to create gap. It also provides negative and positive values. By default, it shows null value, which is 0. If you choose negative values, it will reduce the distances between two alphabet. Same things applies to positive value also. Here also, you can feed the value manually. By default, the negative value is 100 and positive value is 200. It will only work on individual spaces, not on whole text, like tracking option. Next option is horizontal and vertical scaling of typeface. It allows you to change the height and width of text, paragraphs, and individual letters. Use horizontal scaling to change the height of the text. To change, select the text or part of the text on which you want to apply the properties. Feed the percentage value in the horizontal scaling feed box. By default, the percentage value is 100. The height of the selected text will change depending on the feed value. For example, 50%, 110%. Same process also followed in vertical scaling. Next option is shift baseline. It allows you to shift the base of individual character or text to upward or downward from the current base position in a line. To shift the baseline, select the text and feed the point value. To move upward, feed positive value and feed negative to move downward. By default, point value is 0. It will shift base position of the selected text horizontally, up and down from the baseline. Next option is color. It allows you to apply colors to the selected text. To apply color, select the whole text or portion of text or an individual letters. Then click on color option. It will display you color picker windows. Pick color to apply color to text. By default, it display only web color mode. Select the color and press OK. It will automatically apply the selected color to the text. You can apply different colors to the different letters in a text or words in a sentence. Next is additional type options. It provides 8 different settings, which allows you to perform additional settings on selected text. First option is Faux, bold. Second, Faux, italic. Third, all caps. Fourth, small caps. Fifth, superscript. Sixth, subscript. Seventh, underline. Last one is striking through. Let's see what it offers. You may be familiar with these options. These are some of the basic functions provided by any text editors. Faux, bold, which can be used to create fake bold styles when the font you're using doesn't include them. In general, every font comes with the properties like bold, italic, regular, and narrow. For example, font style, Times New Roman, it provide different font weight like bold, italic, regular, and narrow. But few font style doesn't have the these characters, so, in that situation, you can apply faux bold or faux italic to create fake bold and italic character. Faux, italic, same as bold function, it allow you to create fake italic styles when the font you're using doesn't include them. All caps, option, I'm sure you're all familiar with this option, which lets you convert small letters to capital letters, in the same way that Photoshop does. Small caps option, on the other hand, allow you to convert letters in capital letters, while maintaining sentence case. Let us examine the text in sentence case. When you select the text and then click on small caps, the small letters are converted to capital letters, meanwhile maintaining the sentence case format. It keeps the first letter big and capital, and changes the rest of the small letters to capital letters, while keeping the size of the small letters. The function will not produce effects if the font family doesn't have small letters. Next is superscript option. It allow you to reduce the selected text size, usually smaller than the rest of the text, and placed it at or below the cap height line. While subscript allow you to reduce the selected text and placed it at or below the baseline. Subscripts and superscripts are perhaps most often used in formulas, mathematical expressions, and specifications of chemical compounds and isotopes, but have many other uses as well. Next option is underline. This function you can find any text editing software. It allow you to underline selected text only. Striking through allow you to draw a line in the middle of selected text only. This can be used if you want to give strike out some text. So, this is the last option. I have discussed all the options that are available under the toggle the character and paragraph properties of text. I hope I am able to make you understand all the options. If you have any doubt or query, you can write down in the comments section. I will clarify it as soon as possible. See you in my next topic, wrap text in Photoshop. I will discuss few tips and trick of wrap text. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to press like button and share with your friends. Subscribe the channel to get notification for upcoming video tutorials.